Hello, in this video, I'm going to show you how to build this. This is a D1 Mini controlling 4-wire PWM 12-volt PC fan. And we've got it to adjust the speed based on the temperature difference between a Dallas temperature module and a threshold temperature that is manually set. Also, this regulator is only powering the D1 Mini, but will work from 5 to 32 volts. So this project will work on 5, 12 or 24 volt fans. Just make sure you power the project with the same voltage your fan uses. There's also an alarm feature that is triggered when the fan is at 100% for more than 10 seconds. So let's get building. So the first thing I'm going to do is put the D1 Mini on our board here. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to put my female connectors on the D1 Mini. Get that ready. And I want to leave two holes down from the top. Let's put this slightly over to the left because everything's going on the right. So there we go. Left two holes. Let's solder that on. So to hold it in place, I'm going to bend the two opposite corners and that will hold it in place while I solder. And let's solder the rest of these pins. So what I'd like to do is go in the opposite corners first. So that's that one done. And then I'm going to push it in and reflow the solder. That way I know it's sitting in there flush. Okay, that looks good. Next thing we need to do is isolate the left and right of these things. And as always, 4mm drill bit. And you can see there, we've completely cut the track. So let's do the rest. Clean up a toothbrush, clean the workspace. And then we just check that just to make sure that all those tracks are nice and cut. Right, now the way I'm working on this board is this is going to be the top side, and then anytime I show you the underside, it's going to be rotated this way. So next thing I need to do is cut five tracks on this side. So hopefully you can see there, I've got the first three cut. I've missed one, then cut the next two. Back on the top of the bolt, I'm going to need a little bit of blue wire, and this is our PWM signal. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to tin the end here just to keep all those strands together, and then we'll trim the blob off at the end. So looking at the board from the top, I want the fourth one up. Here we go, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is going on to that first group of two there, which we cut the track on. So nice lot of solder there. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to reflow it and push the wire in so it sits nice and flush there. And so we can trim that off. There you go, it's on that first one of the group of two there. So look at the top of the board again, it needs to go to that top row. So then I'm going to cut off 10mm past the board. And then because I'm using this silicone wire, I can pinch this to strip it. So what I want to do is I want to put it through that top hole. So I'm going to pinch it over the top of that top hole. A little bit more. Silicone stretch there. So that's lined up with that hole. And then we'll twist that and tin it and we'll put it through. I say this all the time, get yourself a pair of tweezers. When you're building boards, it's really handy to have a set of tweezers. And we'll pop that into the first hole. So again, I'm going to solder it on just to hold it in place, and then I'm going to reflow it and then just push it back through so that it's in there nice and neat. Trim it off, first jumper. Next, 1K resistor. So I'm going to make this vertical. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to hold the body, just bend that over there. And then just make my life easier, I'm just going to trim those two off so they're equal length. This needs to go between the fifth and the sixth pin. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. And I'm going to leave a space and put that in 5 and 6, and you'll see why the reason I left the space there is because there's a hole. So again, I'm going to bend one over just to hold the component in while I solder the other one onto that track there. Nice bit of heat, so to make sure the track's nice and warm. Check that it's lined up, and then we'll just bend that one back over and solder that one in. Let's do this the right way around so we can follow the convention. The second wire there is on that third hole up that we cut. So that's done. Again, we'll check. These tracks are quite close, so it can be beneficial to check every time. So you look clean, and we'll trim that off. Next up is a power supply. Now, this little thing, these are great. These are a TO220 package, the same pin spacing as these, but because it's got all the circuitry on board, you don't need all the extra capacitors and stuff. So with the components facing the D1 Mini, this is going to line up with the bottom three holes there. So in line with the resistor, that's going to go on the first three there. Resting that down on the board itself. Clean my solder iron, blob a solder on, and then I'm going to do the middle pin first. Nice lot of heat on there. And you can see there, it's gone all over the place, but because I've only soldered one, it's going to be easy to fix. Clean my iron again, find that middle pin on the bottom of the board. I'm going to heat it up, and then I can push that in and get it all lined up. Again, no shorts, you don't have to, but I like to cut these just to make sure that all my joints are roughly the same height. That's the regulator done. Next up, we're going to put the MOSFET in. These get a little bit dirty sometimes, so I'm just going to clean them up a little bit. So the MOSFET is facing away from the board. That's obviously the back where the heatsink is. So this one's in line with the connector there. So I'm going to miss two, and I'm going to put this in line with the body of that regulator there. That's going to go just there. But you can see there the three pins are aligned with the top of that socket. The first one being the top of that resistor. So we'll get that soldered in. Again, I'm going to do the middle one. So that's going to take quite a bit of heat because the middle one's connected to the metalwork here, so it's going to sink out a lot of heat. So we'll get that in. That's done. That's nicely lined up already. So we'll do the other two. These should be a little bit easier because the component itself is warmed up a little bit now. So it won't take so much heat to get the solder to melt. So we'll just make sure that all of those are nicely on there. Again, as always, check your work as you go. Yep, that seems to be nice and clear. Let's cut these up. You don't have to make that noise. It helps sometimes. So just clean the work area off from time to time. Just make sure you've got no stray bits of metal there that's going to get stuck in between these tracks. Next up, we need a black wire between these two components. So this one gets a 0 volt supply. So obviously black wire here. Strip that off and we'll turn it. And this wire needs to be from the middle pin of our regulator there. So we can come in just behind that and we'll just solder that in there. And again, we'll tidy it up by just putting on the wire to get it nice and straight. And then we'll just melt the board and push that, putting a bit of pressure on the wire so it sits flush on the board there. And then this wire here needs to go up to the top pin of the MOSFET there. So again, we're gonna cut it about 10 mil past where I want it to go. And then I'm gonna strip the insulation off in line with the hole. And then we'll give that a twist. Oh, we shall tin it. And then tweezers again. And we'll just bend that roughly 90 degrees. And then that should line up with that hole there. Let's try and get it going through straight. Middle pin from our regulator. Third pin, if you like, if this is the front of the MOSFET. And then we'll solder that on that pin there. Next thing we need to do, that's 0 volts to there. We don't want this going anywhere else. So we'll turn the board over this way. And then the next hole across from that black wire that we just soldered on, I'm gonna drill the track out to the right of that. So we just take that hole. So there you go, I've just put another hole there. And that is at the top of that black wire there. Next, I'm gonna add the headers. Now I'm gonna put two on this board because I can. From that wire, I'm gonna leave three spaces, put a header in. I'm gonna leave another three spaces, put another header in. So this is a bit tricky. Let's do the other hand here. So these headers, they need to go on the... Look, I can't do stuff right-handed. Oh, mate, tweezers. Okay, so I'm going to leave three holes there and the top pin of this header is going to go on that top track, like so. Now, this is going to be a bit of a juggling act, so let's try... Let's give that spin to rest on. Is that going to work? It is. So I'm going to hold that in there with a finger. And we'll solder the top one. We'll get one of those pins holding everything in. Again, just make sure that flows. That looks lined up to me. Okay, let's do the others. So that's the first one. And we'll do the same for the second one. I'll leave a space of three. Okay, getting there. Next, we're going to put in the terminal block. I'm going to line this up with this first pin. It doesn't matter. It could be anywhere along these tracks here. I'm going to miss two from this bottom row. And we're going to put it in the third one down. Like so. So the pin's a little bit thicker. We might have to wiggle these in a little bit. There it goes. And then just to check, looking at the bottom of the board again, in this orientation, the bottom one lines up with the middle pin of our regulator. And the top one won't line up with anything, but we're going to short these two tracks together to get what is going to be the 12 volts in to the regulator there. So we'll solder those two on. Nice blob of solder. These are quite thick pins. We want to make a good first contact. And again, we're waiting for the track to heat up. The pin itself is taking quite a lot of the heat off my iron. So there it goes. And then the track should be fairly warm because it'll conduct across these two through the substrate of the board. So again, nice lot of solder there. Again, it's quite a big pin. So that's those two on. And then these two tracks, we need to short cross so that the 12 volts, which is on the screw terminal here, goes to the top pin of our regulator there, which is the bottom pin on the underside of the board. So I'm going to short across and put some solder down on this track next to it, and then just big blob of solder across those two. So I've got those two tracks shorted together, and as you can see, that middle one of those three there goes down to our regulator. Back onto the top of the board, we just need one more connection, and that's the supply from this terminal here, which is 12 volts in, to the second pin up, which is 12 volts on the fans. And being 12 volts, it's going to be a yellow wire. So this one, I'm going to do the same. Actually, I am going to do this one slightly different. I'm not going to be able to get in there with the cutters or my fingers. I'm going to eye it up. So I want the top track there to the second pin there, which is just about there. So I'm going to cut that a little bit more than I need. And then I'm just going to strip the wire like so. And then we'll tin the other side. Nice lot of solder there. And then we'll trim that off. That's already trimmed. And then hopefully, if we bend that there and that there, that should fit quite nicely. So we want the top pin in there and the second pin there. Well, look at that. It actually worked. That's going to fall out if I tip it up. So I'm just going to put my finger on it. I'm going to bend one down. And I can work on one so it's held. So again, get the ball the right way up. That's the other side of that single hole that we drilled earlier on when we put the black wire in. But let's get this soldered on. And then just to check, that's going on to that dual blobbed 12 volts input supply for the board. So we'll trim those off. We'll give it a little brush. So now the ball's done, let's cut this down to size. Reasonably sharp standing knife or blade, any sort of blade really. I'm gonna leave myself a couple of pins there just to, for mounting purposes. I'm gonna score that a couple of times. Not the best thing to do on your silicone mat, but there you go. And we'll just break that off there. And then we'll do the same here. Now the D1 Mini will stick out a little bit at the bottom. So I'm gonna cut it, cut the pins down. So that was just above that line. So we'll just cut this. We'll cut this on the holes this time. Maybe we won't. Oh, shaky, shaky camera. Sorry about that. We'll do the other side. And then hopefully, another thing I like to do with these boards is I fold them down anyway, so it doesn't matter if it makes a little bit of a mess. And let's put some wires on a Dallas sensor. And for this, I'm going to use a red, a black, and a white. Obviously, this will be the length for your cabinet. So from where the control board is to where you want the Dallas sensor to detect the temperature, make the wires appropriately long. You want to do this quite quickly. This will heat up quite fast. So I'm going to leave a blob on each one. I'm going to say that the flat part there is the front or top. So first one is the black wire, white in the middle, and then red at the end. Bit of heat shrink. So three lengths for that. There's an overall bit of heat shrink on everything. And that gives a nice, neat package like that. So let's connect this to the board. Let's do the white one first. This is going up here on this side and we want the third pin up. So other side of these holes, so a couple in, we'll do one, two, three up, third one up. The black one, that's 0 volts. And 0 volts on this side is the second one up. We want 5 volts for the data sensor. And that's the bottom pin on the D1 Mini, which is the one next to it. On the bottom there, and there you go, nice and neat. I've rounded off the corners, put some extra heat shrink and twisted the wires of the data sensor, and I've also marked up the 0 volt on the terminal block. This is the 0 volts there, and also this is the 0 volts of the fans. And if I show you one of the fans here, if we look at the, just about to see the wires in there, black is that first one, blue, which is the PWM signal, is on the right there, so that matches up like so. Right, join me in part two, where I flash the D1 Mini, add the entities to Home Assistant, and I'll talk you through the ESP Home code.
Okay!